Today we have the pleasure on WatchMojo.com to sit down and chat with Chantal Chamandy with her new CD, Love Needs You, and her hit single, Feels Like Love. It's such a pleasure today to sit down with Chantal and find out about her exciting ventures that made her an internationally acclaimed music superstar. And your CD pretty much signifies love. And what inspired you to come out with this album? You know, signifies love, romance, your true being to yourself.
You know what, that's a very good question, because I don't think that there is a day that we can call Valentine's just being one day. I think Valentine's Day should be every day for women just as much as men, because love should be enjoyed every day and it should be celebrated. So I think that, you know, we have love in our lives every day, whether it's with our children, our husbands, our friends, and I think it should be talked about and it should be in motion more often.
When did you start singing? I know you speak five languages. You've got Lebanese, Greek background. You're kind of that Egyptian. I think you've said before that if you could sing in all five languages in once, or if you could sum up your music style, it's pretty much a piece of every part of the world put together.
That's exactly it. I think that, like I said, you know, love has no languages and no boundaries, and I decided to write this bringing in all my roots. And, you know, I am half Greek-Egyptian, I'm Lebanese, my grandparents lived in Italy for, you know, 50 years, and I think I decided to bring a little bit of all the things that I've enjoyed in my life and the people that I've met, and brought them all together and decided to create an album that I think has a little bit for everybody. I think it's like a good menu in a restaurant.
So where do you see your career taking you in terms from now with launching this new CD, which is amazing? I was listening to it on my laptop the other day and I kept replaying and replaying and replaying, and it kind of put me in this transient ambience of love and romance, and I thought, where is my partner? I don't have one yet. Well, and what about you? Who's the love of your life?
You know, I've been very lucky. I married my soulmate.
Okay.
And we've been together for, you know, quite a while. And it's like, to me, it's like I said before, you know, I try to make it exciting and enjoyable and peaceful. I think that's really what I would define as love, is there's a certain serenity about loving somebody and not having to be on all the time.
Okay.
And that's how I
So in the production of your CD, I know that you are like the control, the talent, and you took it all on, and you pretty much produced this whole album yourself. You wrote, produced, you worked in the studios and critiqued the music to be exactly your style. So it comes from your heart and it really signifies you.
It really does. And, you know, it's very easy to say that, you know, I did this and this and this. And you know, granted I did, it's my career and I want to be completely in control of it. But I surround myself with great people and people who have the same vision as me, and people who, you know, really believe in what I believe in, because I think that's the real essence of being an artist, is to do what you really truly believe in. And if you can gather a whole bunch of people who believe in what you do, then you have an amazing team.
So if you had to talk to young kids, because I know you're really a mentor to a lot of young girls, how did you become who you are today, and what steps did you take to set your goals to accomplish all of your achievements right now in your life?
Well, number one, never give up on the dream. Never let anybody tell you that that you can't do it. And remember not to compromise what you've always believed in. And I think that that's what happens, is that, you know, when you're really, really young and you're starting in this business, I think you get lost in the shuffle. And unless you have an amazing person behind you, as, you know, as most really very big artists did, whether it's the people that they married or people that have worked with them their whole lives, those are the people who really, really want you to succeed. And that's really the bottom line, because a lot of people want a piece of you, and they all want to, you know, they all want to say, I was part of it. And then when it doesn't work out, everybody walks away. So
no,
I think
exactly.
If they stay true to their music, and no matter what people tell them, stay true to your music and keep doing what you love and don't compromise yourself, I think that you have a pretty good chance.
And do you love WatchMojo.com?
I do.
WatchMojo.com?
I totally do. And I'm so glad you guys are here.
Well, it was
today.
Such a pleasure today.
It's a pleasure.
Thanks
it's
so much.
Valentine's
Join
right?
on WatchMojo.com
Thank
with
you.
Chantal Chamandy and Calvin Sims.
Thank you.